After failing for the third time to appear before Parliament to seek approval to keep Ugandan troops in Democratic Republic of Congo, where they are fighting ADF rebel outfit, the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Anita Moin, has told Parliament that the Ministers of Defense went to the battlefield to protect Ugandans, which is why they have not showed up.
The ministers are in the field and they have written to me as per Rule 114 that they may not be able to be here because they are busy protecting and securing the lives of Ugandans.
This came after members of parliament, led by Lwemiyaga County legislator Theodore Sechikubo, expressed the continued violation of Article 210D of the Constitution, which compels government to seek clearance of parliament to deploy national forces abroad. MPs have revived the demand for government to appear before parliament and sanitize the Congo mission.
I raise on a matter of procedure under Rule 42 and Rule 50 of our rules of procedure that provide for questions asked of ministers relating to public affairs with which they are officially connected, proceedings pending in parliament, or any matter of administration for which the ministers are responsible.
Within that ministry, we have three. We have three ministers. We still also have a leader of government business. We have a deputy leader of government business. So among us, the five, including even the vice president who sits in the house. So we have like six members of the executive who can come and give that statement. And I think they're just being defiant.
The ministers are allowed not to be in parliament as long as they have permission. Rule 114 of our rules of procedure is very clear that when a minister is not around, these ministers are handling very sensitive issues, on deployment, on very, very sensitive issues. But the government is here, and the matter is on order paper. So whenever we reach on order paper, we shall give our position as a government. But now we are handling the bill.
Meanwhile, Amnesty Commission has disclosed to the Parliament's Committee of Defence and Internal Affairs that some ADF rebels have started applying for amnesty following intensified UPDF attacks on their camps in eastern DRC. While facing the Parliamentary Committee of Defence and Internal Affairs, the officials of the Amnesty Commission revealed that ADF have started expressing interest and want to be aided.
I heard some news that there are some people who have surrendered, but we don't work on hearsay until when we get official communication from government or from our office. We are working hand in hand with MONUSCO, the UN agency, to repatriate those people. And once we get that information, we shall be able to receive them.
Led by the acting secretary of the commission, the committee learned that even some terror suspects who were charged together with Jamil Mukulu have applied for amnesty and the verification process is ongoing.
What we do is we don't force a person to apply for amnesty. It's up to them to indicate, and we work together with the prison officers, the OCs. They tell them, and I can confirm that one of them who is charged with Mukulu has approached the OC. He has invited me. I have given the form which he has filled.
969 rebels have been demobilized, pardoned and resettled in 5 years by the Amnesty Commission, with 404 from ADF, 542 from Lord's Resistance Army and 23 from other rebel groups. Nathan Tunomujeni, the principal legal officer of the commission, confirmed to the committee that Sheikh Abbas Chirevu, who was recently gunned down by security agencies while pursuing him in connection to the recent bomb attacks in Kampala, was a former rebel who received amnesty in 2005.
I want to know specifically. You have heard about the person who was murdered in cold blood by the forces this side of Chengera, called Chirevu. For this one, I want you to tell us, who was Chirevu? Has he ever been ADF rebel?
I can confirm that Chirevu was asked for amnesty and we granted it in the year 2005.
From which group and
The group is not, he wasn't very clear, but what I can confirm to you is that he asked for amnesty and we granted it.
However, the committee was left puzzled with the miserable package extended to amnesty beneficiaries, including 5 kilograms of posho, saying that it's too little to resettle and reintegrate former insurgents. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.